explain how to divide polynomials, simple synthetic division of a polynomial. For example, we are given x cubed plus 5x squared minus 3x plus 1 divided by x using a long division, what we call synthetic division. So we have x plus 1, so you rule a line like this. You will put in your x raised to power 3 plus 5x squared minus 3x plus 1. So if you want to divide this polynomial, it's very simple. X cubed divided by this. Now what, how many x can we go here? We have x squared. X squared times this, we have x cubed. X squared times this one, we have plus x. So you x squared, you rule a line and introduce minus. That minus that you introduce affects everything down here. That shows that this guy changes to minus, this guy also changes to minus. So x cubed minus x cubed will strike off. So we have 5x squared minus x squared, we have 4x squared. The next thing is to bring down the next number, minus 3x. So now x goes in 4x squared is plus 4x, plus 4x. Now plus 4x times x, we have 4x squared. 4x times 1, we have plus 4x. So you also rule a line and introduce minus again. Like I said earlier, this minus sign is affecting everything that we have here. Now that this one is plus, it will change it to what? Minus. So this guy strike off, minus 3x minus 4x, we have minus 7x. And you bring down the next number, which is plus 1. X goes here is minus 7. Minus 7 times x is minus 7x. Minus 7 plus times 1, you have minus 7. You rule a line again and you introduce your minus. So this minus sign is affecting everything that we have here. So this guy is strike off. So minus times minus is plus. So we have 1 plus this, we have 8. So this is how we divide this. So when we divide this, this guy is what we call our remainder. This is the remainder. So the remainder, when you divide this number by x plus 1, is 8. So of course, we can use remainder theorem to solve this, but that is not the concept of this video. All right, the next one is divide x raised to power by this. So I'll rule a line. So we have x minus 2. Now, after we have x raised to power 5, the next number is supposed to be x raised to power 4. So I'm going to do plus 0x raised to power 4. I've not changed anything. Now this x raised to, this 0, now 0 times x is still 0. So nothing has changed. So we still have, because I want the power to reduce in order. So the next one is, we have minus 3x squared. Now after minus 3x cubed. Now after 3x cubed, I'm supposed to have x squared. But what we have is 0x square, 0x square. Now the 0 has no effect. I just want the power to reduce from 5, 4, 3, 2, and so on and so forth. Now we have, then plus x, then minus 5. So let's see how we divide this, right? X goes in x raised to power 5 is x raised to power 4. X raised to power 4 times x is x raised to power 5. X raised to power 4 times 2 is minus 2x raised to power 4. You rule a line and introduce your minus sign. Now, when you introduce your minus sign, like I said earlier, this minus sign is affecting everything that we have down here. So this guy will strike off. So minus times this is plus. So 2 plus 0, we have 2x raised to power 4. And you bring down the next guy, 3x raised to power 3. Alright, so x goes in 2x raised to power 4 is plus 2x raised to power what now? 3. 2x raised to power 3 times this, we have a 2x raised to power of 4. 2x raised to power 3 times 2, we have minus 4x raised to power 3. You rule a line again and introduce minus. Now this minus sign is affecting everything that we have down here. Now that is correct, this guy will strike off, minus times minus is plus, so 3 minus 3 plus 4 is you have x raised to power 3, and you bring down the next guy, which is plus 0x squared. You have plus 0x squared. So x goes here is plus x raised to power 2. This time this, we have, if I multiply, we have x raised to power 3. This time this, we have minus 2x. Minus 2x raised to power of, minus 2x raised to power of what now? 2. So you rule a line and introduce minus. So if you rule a line and introduce minus, I'm going to, now this minus sign is affecting everything that we have here. So now we, this guy will cancel out. Minus times minus is plus. So we have 2x squared. Now bring down the next number, which is x. So your x again goes in 2x raised to power 2 is plus 2x. 2x times x, we have 2x squared. 2x times this 4, we have minus 4x. You rule a line and introduce minus again. That's just a simple principle. So now, this guy is strike off. This time, this is plus. So we have 5x. Bring down the next guy, minus 5. So x goes here is plus 5. This time, this is 5x. This 5 times this is minus 10. So you rule a line and introduce minus. So this guy is strike off. So this and this is 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. Because this x cannot go here again, this is where we stop. So when you divide that guy, our remainder in this case, our remainder is 5. When you divide this polynomial by x minus 2. So that is how we divide a polynomial simply. We can also use what we call remainder theorem, but that will be explained in the next video. Thank you very much. All right.